The diagnosis of TTP is particularly challenging. It is a rare disease, which means it is not seen frequently in clinics and emergency departments. The clinical and biochemical features overlap with other TMAs and acute disorders, yet treatments differ, so differential diagnoses must be ruled out. TTP often has an acute onset and rapid progression, so a quick diagnosis is critical to minimize the risk of mortality, as well as consequences of long-term sequelae. Finally, diagnosis can be complicated if ADAM TS13 testing is not available. In the prodromal phase of ITTP, patients typically present with fatigue, low-grade fever, and headaches. In the acute phase, signs and symptoms are similar to those of other TMAs and critical disorders such as acute stroke and sepsis. Due to the combination of thrombocytopenia and thrombosis, clinical presentation is highly variable. Symptoms related to brain dysfunction occur in approximately 60% of cases. It may include paresis, aphasia, dysarthria, visual problems, headache, confusion, stroke, coma, and seizure. Gastrointestinal problems are present in about 35% of cases and include abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. Cardiac symptoms occur in about 25% of cases and may include chest pain, hypotension, isolated electrocardiographic abnormalities, myocardial infarction, congestive heart failure, arrhythmias, cardiogenic shock, and sudden cardiac arrest. If the acute episode progresses without treatment, multi-organ failure is possible. Results of blood tests at presentation are similar to other TMAs. Notably, the platelet count is very low, less than 30 times 10 to the 9th per liter, and there is evidence of MAHA, hemoglobin and hematocrit are low, haptoglobin is consumed, LDH is elevated, and schistocytes are present in the peripheral blood smear. Renal function is relatively normal, creatinine levels usually less than 2.25 milligrams per deciliter. Ideally, the diagnosis is based on activity of ADAM TS13, and the diagnostic algorithm diverges, depending on the availability of testing for plasma ADAM TS13 activity and anti-ADAM TS13 antibodies. If testing is available, a plasma sample should be acquired before starting treatment. Treatment will depend on the level of suspicion of ITTP based on clinical presentation and timing of test result availability. For treatment options, see the treatment and management video. An ADAM TS13 activity below 10 international units per deciliter confirms a diagnosis of TTP. The presence of antibodies confirms ITTP, and the absence points towards CTTP. But ADAM TS13 genetic testing is required to confirm CTTP. If ADAM TS13 activity is greater than 25%, TTP is unlikely. Activity of 10 to 25% may indicate borderline TTP or other diagnoses. If ADAM TS13 level test is not available, two clinical scoring methods, the French score and the plasmic score, can be used to predict the probability of severe ADAM TS13 deficiency in suspected TTP.